Worldwide, hundreds of thousands of people are on official waiting lists, waiting for a life-saving organ transplant. Our company was founded on a passion to help improve outcomes in transplantation. That passion was born of an event in my life where my father found himself on a waiting list for a life-saving heart transplant, and his heart was going to show up in a box of ice, and that was going to be the difference in whether he lived or died. And that became the basis for organ recovery systems. LifePort Kidney Transporter is the leading machine preservation device in the world, owning the definitive market share of machines used for the preservation of kidneys for transplantation. We started out with an idea to build a machine preservation device for kidneys that could really make a difference. And we took the position that we knew nothing and spent a couple of years living with industry before we even put pen to paper. We started with an idea in 1998. Was cleared by the FDA in 2003, and in 2009, pivotal trial evidence was published in the New England Journal of Medicine. We purposefully wanted an iconic look to the device, and apparently it worked. The LifePort was invited into the permanent collection of the Museum of Modern Art in New York City. One of the big challenges with the box of ice is that it's static cold storage. And the natural estate of the organ is to be perfused, not to be sitting in a static environment. To improve upon static cold storage, LifePort Kidney Transporter perfuses the organ, bathes it with a physiologic solution while the organ is being preserved and transported. One of the other limitations of the box of ice is there's no data. The LifePort Transporter captures and transmits data about the performance of the organ while it's being preserved. The scientific literature is pointing to a strong contribution from machine preservation that suggests that it should be the standard of care for the recovery and preservation of donor kidneys.
The data between pump kidneys and ice kidneys is that the delayed graft function rate for pump kidneys probably runs around 10-20% at the very high end, whereas cold stored kidneys, it's not uncommon for them to have 30-40% delayed graft function. There's plenty of data to show that delayed graft function is a negative in terms of long-term graft survival. By pumping kidneys, not only for high KDPI, but also for DCD kidneys, we're able to be confident that those kidneys are gonna do very well after we put them in. The primary reason that we use a LifePort is for resistive indices and flow. Those are the two main parameters that as a surgeon, I wanna know.
Researching and developing new innovations in transplantation is the lifeblood of our company. We have well over 200 patents that have been issued and are pending. Probably closest to market right now and most exciting is our LifePort Liver Transporter, which is built upon the same platform as our LifePort Kidney Transporter. Any improvement in the quality and the availability of donor organs will make a very important contribution to not just the lives of these patients, but their families and their loved ones. It is that energy, it's that passion that to this day is the DNA of our organization. It's what drives us. The people that we hire, very passionate, wanting to give back, wanting to help, because we've all lived and seen the benefits of what transplantation can do to transform lives.